Thank you so much for joining us here today. So in looking over your testimony and the governor's budget proposal, I note that the operating budget for the Department of Corrections is very expensive. $2.78 billion from the general fund, which means that taxpayers are responsible for paying 96% of this department's budget. Now, it seems to me that your budget, more so than many other departments, is directly impacted by what happens in this chamber. For example, if we pass more mandatory minimum bills that keep folks in prison for a longer amount of time, that will drive your budget up. And in contrast, criminal justice reform bills like the Justice Reinvestment Initiative can lower your costs by reducing the prison population in a responsible way. So my first question is, do you have any opinion on what criminal justice reform proposals we could vote on in this chamber that would drive your costs down for taxpayers?
We are continuing to implement the elements of the Justice Reinvestment Initiative too. Certainly continuing that would be a good start. We've talked a little bit about the compassionate release. Certainly would be another measure that we think would particularly target a population that you talked about costs. Certainly would have a significant cost impact. Let me suggest that on the other end, investment for our children, right? So Washington State did a study years ago as their prison population was exploding. And they identified that proactive measures for the 6, 7, 8-year-olds had tremendous return on investment down the road. We've talked about juvenile justice and juvenile justice reform. So I think that you can't just focus on the Department of Correction, but you have to look at certainly early childhood. You have to look at juvenile justice. And then also what happens in terms of encounters with local criminal justice agency. One of our earlier speakers referenced his involvement in Lancaster County with Lancaster County Prison. I think if we can do a better job of impacting individuals when they hit our local prisons, particularly with like substance abuse disorders, and that's a big driver. Mental health was alluded to earlier. So it isn't all just about the Department of Correction, because my experience has been when the rest of the social safety net has failed, oftentimes, that's when individuals end up in our Department of Correction.
I appreciate that. And I remember learning during my first year on the Appropriations Committee that we could pay for 8 kids in high-quality pre-K for the cost of every one individual in our state system. So I agree with you that investing in things like education is incredibly important. Reducing recidivism also would be a cost saver because we would have less folks returning to the state system. Can you talk about any workforce development efforts that have been particularly successful to help folks to be able to support themselves and their families once they are released from a state facility?
Well, I mentioned a moment ago in the context of hiring correctional officers some of the challenges we face in terms of competition, but if there is another side to that coin, it is that right now, if a reentrant wants work, they can find a job. I think the problem there, though, is having difficulty in finding a career. So we talked a bit earlier about our education programs inside, both in terms of general academic and vocational programming. So connecting individuals with careers is certainly an opportunity. You may be aware that there's, in terms of logistics chain, there are shortages there. There's a shortage of CDL, commercial driver's license qualified individuals. So I think expanding programs in that space, and that certainly is one that we would be interested in collaborating with state institutions that have driving programs, perhaps the trucking industry, because we have men and women inside whose offenses in some cases may preclude them working in that space. Others could qualify, and so if we could amp up in that space, that could have a fairly immediate benefit. And so we are looking to expand. We have 3 simulators now. We'd like to expand that program, not only with simulators, but entertain some other ways to tie back to the community, because I think one of the barriers to that opportunity is just the cost of qualifying.
Thank you. And I do want to note that your Deputy Secretary said earlier that you've got a goal of making sure that everyone has an ID and Social Correct. Security card in hand when they leave. I just went to visit the Career Link in Delaware County in the city of Chester, which is right down the street from SCI Chester, a few weeks ago. And in talking to their staff, they noted that the lack of ideas was the biggest barrier to employment for those folks. Even though it's something you're working towards, they've got plenty of people showing up with no ideas, and it takes much longer to place them in a job. So please make progress towards that goal. We need it. Thank you.